Hello, law aspirants, and meeting the teacher every day and learning a lot of vocabulary and, you know, that personal individualized touch you must be feeling on cloud nine, on seventh heaven, that euphoric feeling and that larky attitude. Yes, that's what we want from you and your performance and your result. Right. So let's begin with our vocabulary section today. Since in the last class only I discussed with you about the reading section and what are the things that you're supposed to read. So today, let's start with directly our root section. Right. You have been reading, I hope, the novel section. You must have chose. You must be quite aware what is right and wrong for you and must have be there. If you want me to choose for you, there's no problem. I would tell my personal preference. But see, students, it's your choice what you want to read. But do read. Again and again, I insist, reading makes a complete man. Francis Bacon, the father of English essays, said so. It's not an age-old adage or a saying. It is something which is really true in the real sense of the terms, right? So beginning with our section of vocabulary here. And the things here, beginning with our root section. The last root we did was aster root, that is star. This is a very interesting root. But I tell you one thing, don't be confused. You bring up words with it like, ma'am, A means not or without. Any word like with A will not work. What works is, I explain you. In this, you have to keep in mind one thing. Like if you are making up an example, so it should be A plus pathy and the word comes out to be apathy. Right? This word and this word has meaning. A means not, pathy means feelings. So a person who is without feelings, a person, the synonyms we have for this word, a person who is stoic, a person who is insouciant, a person who is indifferent, or a person who is nonchalant. This is all the list of the synonyms of the word apathy linked with it. Not having feelings, not caring, not affected by anything, that is apathy. See the first word. So you've understood it's only going to work when you have the second part has a meaning here. Amnesia. This is memory and this is not. So this means not able to remember. You have a memory loss. This is amnesia, is a memory loss. The person is not able to remember and that means amnesia, right? So this is you've seen various films. A film of Amir Khan had come long back, that was Ghazni, and that was having that short-term memory loss, you know, that sparkle in your eyes. I can see that because films make a mark on your mind. Yes, so he was suffering from that Alzheimer disease, which is also connected with amnesia, right? Apathy, right now only we discussed this word. Apathetic is not caring, being stoic, insouciant, indifferent or nonchalant. Do write these synonyms, it's going to really help you. It's a very important synonym. Asocial, clear from the word. A plus social, that means not social. You are quite maybe in your closets, in your clusters and you do not come out of it. Apolitical, being not political. You don't, like I say, politics is not my cup of tea. So in that case, I would mean is something where I would mean is politics I'm not interested in. Atheist, see there's a difference in some words I would talk of, like A plus theist. Now what is theist? Believer of God, one who believes in God. So A means not, person who doesn't believe in God. Do not get confused. A person who does not believe in religion is called agnostic. A person who believes that nature is the form of God is a pagan or a pantheist. A person who does not believe in idol worship is iconoclast. There shouldn't be confusion in that. There's a difference in all of these three to four terms, right? Okay. I hope it is clear. You have jotted down specially the synonym for the word apathy. Right? Okay. A very common root. Mm-hmm. this means shape. You would use this word. We are amorphous. We have a shape, and God is amorphous. We haven't seen God. God is amorphous because it's without shape. You've heard of morphemes, morphology, and this is all related with the shape, all the system. Morphology is a part of phonetics, where the words, how do they change with the combination in plural or the pronunciation that is being discussed. So that is morphology, right? Now, turning to a simple word like atom, this is particle which cannot be cut, which cannot be broken. So, this is atom, you could say. Anemia. So, A plus, this means blood. So, there is not enough blood in person's body to survive, and means lack of hemoglobin or red blood cells. That would be not enough blood in a person's body to survive. So anemia is also like malnutrition, right? Analgesic. This is more asked in the analogy section. This is without pain. See, this is also A, and there's sometimes also one more root which I really want to discuss with you. A means not, and even an means not. Both mean in the context of without. Both mean the context of without, right? So this would mean in the sense of without. So analgesic is not with pain or without pain. So an or a plus analgesic, this is a painkiller. Simple words like abiotic, without bios, that means life. A form of anything which like morpheme, jaise humne discuss kiya. So same way we could have is anything which is any word. A terrorist, that would be without terrorism a country. So it's very simple to frame various words. See, I've always told you, the words I'm giving you, they are not an end in itself. You have to frame new words, more words. The more you do, the better it is. Yes, so do write up in your inbox. Do tell me which new words you framed, what were the doubts, what things you came across. Yes, thank you. And turning to next word in this, I hope you've jotted it down. The next word is anarchy. You can see this an also coming up. So that is why I told you a and an, both meaning in the sense of not. So we have a root, we have an root. We have arc root, we have nim root in this. This both mean not. This with cressi means a rule. And this nim means a name. I have to, since I did not write that, so I'm writing again. Right. And this pulia. So, anarchy is a state of having a, not having a central ruling power, not having a central authority in a country or a nation. This is a total chaos or a confusion, a total anarchic state without any ruler. Turning to anonymous, without name. You know, in my childhood, when my teacher said, the poet of this poem is anonymous. It took me a long time to learn the word anonymous. And now this word is so fruitful for me here. So anonymous is without name. It doesn't have a name. The identity is not known. Sometimes it's a pen name people write it. Like Robert Ladd, the writer of Forgetting, he writes by the pen name of YY. Or like Charles Lamb was to write with the pen name of Ilya, and Addison by Spectator. So these are the pen names, the pseudonyms that they write it. Gardner by Elf of the Plough, right? Abelia is not able to take decisions, so it's an indecisive state, indetermined state. you are not able to decide what to do and what not to do. That is abhilya, right? Moving to more words. I hope you've written down all the six roots in this. If you find, although I'm moving at a pace where students can write, but still if you feel that you've not written it and it's not being done, so please do let me know. Turning to our next root, anti. See, don't confuse, I discussed already six roots here with you. So, I have to take up the root anti, this is against, and this is the anti, which means before. Anti-chamber, anti-nuptial, we had, now we can merge up two roots. Right, so antenuptial before marriage. This could be taken navis ship, yeah, or it could be NAT in the sense of birth. So when we say pre, that also means before. So when I say antenuptial, or I say prenuptial, or I say prenatal. So prenatal, see the word prenatal. That would be, guess, before, and net is birth, so this will be before birth. You remember Abhimanyu's incident in Mahabharata? He learned all the tricks, prenatal, right, prenatal. So anti, before, the first word we take is the only the word anti. The word itself and the root itself. Yes, that's the interesting part of English, which makes it, you know, add it more spicy. To take money for poker game without it begins, aap paise lete ho poker game start karne se pehle. That is called ante. Ante room is a waiting room before the main room. So you can see before and room. When you enter the office or something, so you are asked to wait. Maybe the boss or somebody is busy, and so that is a ante room. Antechamber is a small room. Chamber is a room. So this is something again, it's a small room before the big room. It's usually a dressing room or something that is called antechamber. So if it's clear, anti-room, antechamber. Right, dearies? Okay. Moving on to more words for anti, because I'll have to continue with this in the next video too. So I'll just take up, just discuss with you framing up these words more with this. When we take up this anti with any of the word, like I had framed up, you can frame your own words with it. Antenuptial, before marriage. Antenatal. So this is not, I have supposed to do, I'm sure you would also be able to do it. And so on, the list goes on and on. So this is just something which will add more and more things to it, and you will be easily able to understand. So we'll be in the next class, we will continue with the same, from the same root, because we'll have more, lot of words which we have to discuss with the root anti, right? Okay, thank you students for today. Do like and subscribe our channel, and please be a part of the Lopra family. You'll be adding on lot many things of the English section. Thank you.